Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss about analog circuits in that basic information related to that. Just we are going to see. Myself Ms. Halunde SS, Assistant Professor, Department of Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering. Now let us see about introduction of this lecture. In that, what is op-amp, mathematics of op-amp, characteristics of op-amp, ideal op-amp, types of op-amp, application of op-amp, description of op-amp and application. These points are involved. Then you see that op-amp words come again and again. Now let us see about what is op-amp. Op-amp means an operational amplifier is an integrated circuit that uses external voltage to amplify the input signal a very high gain. Do you know amplification means to increasing the strength of signal? That means nothing but to amplify or to increase the signal strength. This is the IC format related to that op-amp. How that op-amp looks like is clear by using this simple picture. Operational amplifier. Originally an op-amp was an electronic circuit that could carry out mathematical operations of addition, subtraction, differentiation and integration. That means operational amplifier is nothing but operational. Words come from mathematics. Operational means to perform operations. What are the operations involved in our mathematics? Basic operations are addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, like such. And for a higher level mathematics, differentiation and integration operations are involved in that. Apart from that, in op-amp we perform only addition, subtraction, multiplication. Division operation is not performed in op-amp. Okay, then hence the word is a operational. You clear all about that. Then op-amp is used to amplify DC as well as AC signals. What do you mean by DC and what do you mean by AC? DC means direct current and AC means alternating current. Direct current is represented by using straight line and alternating current is represented by using sinusoidal nature. We always convert that direct signal into AC current because of our application purpose. Next, what is an op-amp inside? That means we observe what is the pictorial form of that op-amp IC. Now we are going to see what is the op-amp inside. The actual count varies, but an op-amp contains the several transistors, resistors and few capacitors and diodes. That means op-amp is formed by using these basic components related to our electronics. That is, number of transistors are involved in op-amp, number of resistors are also involved in op-amp and few number of capacitors and diodes are involved in this op-amp. By using these components, this op-amp is formed. For simplicity, an op-amp is often dissipated as, just see here, this is a symbolical diagram of that op-amp. What it seems, it shows one terminal is related to inverting input, another terminal is related to non-inverting input, one terminal is given to positive power supply, one terminal is connected to negative power supply and last is connected to output. That means here number of pins and number of terminals as a considered as a output. These terminals are along with IC, we are going to considering that number of pins required for the representation of this symbolical diagram. That means so and so pin number is assigned to so and so task. That means inverting amplifier is having some pin number, non-inverting terminal is having some pin number. Like this, the pin diagram and symbolical diagram, how it seems like, just we are discussing. This is a pin diagram of op-amp 741. That means number of ICs are used, number of IC series is used for the op-amp representation. Apart from that, 741 IC is called as a op-amp, that means operational amplifier. Frequently we are using 741 IC number for the operational amplifier purposes. Here just see how many number of pins available in op-amp. While connecting that IC in our breadboard, just consider or just keep the notch in front of us and start from left hand side and give the number to the pins like pin number 1, 2, 3, 4 and again from down to up goes, that is a 5, 6, 7, 8, like this. Okay, just this is the pin diagram related to that our IC. From that previous slide we observed that is a symbolical diagram of that op amp. What is since one pin is assigned for inverting, one pin is a non-inverting, one pin is for output, one pin is a supplied for that positive power supply and one pin is a connected for negative power supply. Okay, like this here, see, pin number 1 is a connected to offset null, that means here no any connection is a required for that op amp. Then pin number 2 is a connected for the inverting terminal of the op amp, that means pin number 2 is a considered to give, or it is a considered as a negative terminal of the op amp. Then pin number 3 is a considered as a positive terminal of the op amp, which is called as a non-inverting terminal of the op amp. Then pin number 4 is a considered as a not connected, that is a blanked. Then pin number 5 is a offset null, again it is not connected to anywhere. Then pin number 6 is a connected to output, that means here we are taking output observations. Pin number 7 is a connected to positive power supply and pin number 4 is a connected to negative power supply and 8 number is a not connected, like this. See here, one of the most important pins are here, that is a pin number 2 is a inverting terminal of the op amp, pin number 3 is a non-inverting terminal of the op amp, pin number 6 is the output of the op amp, pin number 7 is a positive power supply of the op amp and pin number 4 is a negative power supply of the op amp. Like this, this is a op amp pin diagram related to our practical purpose. Then next is a mathematics of the op amp. The gain of the op amp itself is calculated as G is equal to V out divided by V positive minus V negative, that means gain. In simply terms, we are always considering the gain of any quantity is a calculated, or what is the basic definition related to gain? Gain is nothing but output quantity divided by input quantity, that means it is a ratio of output divided by input related to any quantity. Here we are always going to deal related to op amp, that is in terms of voltage. For that purpose here I am taking voltage, that means gain is equal to output voltage divided by input voltage. For op amp, what we observe, there are two inputs pins are available for our op amp, that is a positive input and negative input. For that purpose, positive input is a considered as a input given to non-inverting terminal of the op amp and negative input is a given to inverting terminal of the op amp. For that purpose, input is considered as a basically difference in between positive terminal of the op amp and negative terminal of the op amp. That means non-inverting terminal voltage minus inverting terminal voltage is equal to input of that op amp. For that purpose, what is the gain of the op amp? Is gain of the op amp is calculated by the formula G is equal to V out divided by V plus minus V minus maximum output is a power supply voltage. Okay, then maximum output voltage is a power supply voltage. Whatever we are giving, that maximum power supply voltage, it is nothing but that maximum output related to that op amp. Just see, 1 minute, one problem is there. Okay, the main used in a circuit, the gain of circuit as a opposed to a op amp component is V out, that means gain is equal to V out divided by V. Like this, we also calculate the gain. Then op amp characteristics. While designing or while studying any IC, there is an important role related to observe or study number of characteristics related to that component or that particular device. According to this, this is a characteristics of op amp. In that characteristics of op amp, Rout resistance, that means output resistance is involved, input voltage is involved, output voltage is involved, positive supply power supply is involved, negative power supply is also involved, positive supply is nothing but non-inverting terminal of the op amp, negative voltage supply is nothing but that is a inverting terminal of the op amp. Here we are going to see whatever the output introduced by the op amp in detail. Like this, this is in short the characteristics of op amp. Then how we are going to calculate the gain? There are two types of gain involved in op-amp. First one is a differential gain and another one is a common mode gain. First we are going to see about differential gain. How we are calculating that differential gain? Differential gain is calculated by the formula AD is equal to Vout divided by V1 minus V2, where consider V1 is nothing but input to non-inverting terminal of the op-amp, and consider V2 is equal to input to inverting terminal of the op-amp. Then A for representation of a gain in mathematical terminology, we are always considering capital A letter for representation of gain, and for differential gain here I have written at the prefix D. Then another gain is common mode gain, like this AC, common mode gain is written here as AC is equal to Vout divided by V1. Why here I have considered only V1? Because considering V1 is equal to V2, for that common mode gain, both the inverting and non-inverting terminal is having same input voltage. For that purpose, that common mode voltage is V1 is equal to V2. Apart from that, we are considering input voltage either V1 or V2. Op-amp characteristics is the next part in our presentation. In that, first terminology, characteristics of op-amp is a very very important, or why we are going to choose that op-amp for any particular experiment, what are the characteristics factors we have to consider, just see. First, infinite input. Infinite input of op-amp is impedance is about 2 microohm. Low output impedance about 200 ohm, very large voltage gain at low frequency. Thus small changes in a voltage can be amplified by using an op-amp. Then next is a infinite bandwidth, all frequencies are amplified by same factor. Then next is a number of slew rate, no delay between changes in the input and changes in output. That means there is a no change or no delay in between input and output. That means in while or whatever the input is applied to the op-amp, output is at a frequently or shortened time it will changes. For that purpose, there is no any kind of a delay in between input and output. For that purpose, here no slew rate is present. Then continuation with that op-amp characteristics, infinite input impedance, no current flows into inputs. Then infinite voltage gain, a voltage difference at the two inputs is magnified to a very large extent. In practice, voltage gain is about 2 lakhs. Means difference between positive terminals is simplified by 2 lakhs. Again, continuation with op-amp characteristics. Infinite bandwidth, in practice bandwidth limited to a few megahertz range. Slew rate limited, it is a very small, it is a 0.5 to 20 volt per microsecond. Then operational amplifier without feedback. That what, then first of all we are going to see just what is the meaning of feedback. Feedback means output is reversely connected back to the input, then that type of a connection is called as a feedback. Feedbacks are at two types, that is a positive feedback and negative feedback. Feedback forms open loop formation and closed loop formation. It is related to only closed loop formation. That means it closes the loop. That means output is reversely connected towards that input. That means there is a correlation in between input and output. Depending upon that, op-amp is also having positive feedback as well as negative feedback. While we are giving output reversely towards positive terminal of the op-amp, then that type of a feedback related to op-amp is called as a positive feedback. And if suppose we are giving that output reversely towards inverting terminal of the op-amp, that is a negative terminal of the op-amp, then that type of a feedback is called as a negative feedback. Then here what we observe, the op-amp can be regarded as a device which generates a voltage V0 given by V0 is equal to A into V2 minus V1. That means how we are going to calculate output voltage related to op-amp is output voltage is equal to gain into differential input voltage. A is nothing but gain. And here V2 minus V1, what it represents? Differential voltage. For that purpose, V2 is the voltage applied as a non-inverting terminal and V1 is voltage applied at inverting terminal, and A is called as a gain. Then types of op-amp. There are number of types of op-amp depending upon their application and purposes are available in our practices. Apart from that, here I have mentioned a few types of op-amp. Just see: inverting, non-inverting, summing amplifier, the voltage follower, integrator, differentiator. What do we call that is a, or why we are going to categorize like this? Because they have separate meaning individually. Inverting, that means whenever the input is applied to negative terminal of the op-amp, it will give us reversed output. It is a 180 degree out of phase output. For that purpose, here inverting type is involved. Then non-inverting terminal, that means whenever we are giving in any kind of input related to non-inverting, that is a positive terminal of the op-amp, it will give us only whatever the input is applied, that output is amplified only. There is nothing, any kind of a change apart from that amplification. Then summing amplifier, it is related to whatever the inputs given to inverting as well as non-inverting terminal of the op-amp, the summing amplifier will add all these inputs and output is a resultant addition of all these inputs available in inverting as well as non-inverting terminal of the op-amp. Then next is a voltage follower. The voltage follower is also called as a unity gain amplifier, because the voltage follower circuit is designed such that whenever we want from the circuit, that is the output 1, that is the unity gain, then that type of a application follows only voltage follower. Then integrator, in maths, integration means combination of all these inputs were increasing towards the side of constant, then that type of a application is related to integration. And differentiation means what? There is a reduction in that output. Just see, for mathematical operation, integration of any constant, that is x is considered as a any variable, then what is the integration of that x? Integration of x is considered as x square by 2. And what is the differentiation of that x? Differentiation of x is 1. And in integration, we are always adding that constant plus c is always added. That means integration is a increasing purpose we are going to considering, and differentiation is considered for the reduction purpose. Same is mathematical application is followed here also. Then next is a application of op-amp. Where we are going to applying that op-amp? Here I have mentioned some applications. There is a comparator, integrator and differentiation, charge amplifier, capacitance, multiplier, oscillators, filters, audio and video preamplifiers and buffers. Application of op-amp. Along with this, again some number of applications here I also mentioned, that is a voltage regulator and current regulator, digital to analog converter, voltage clamps, oscillators and waveforms generators, analog computers, then comparators. Just see one by one application. Here I have mentioned only the symbol comparator. In that comparator, V1 voltage is given to positive terminal of the op-amp, V2 input is given to negative terminal of the op-amp, and output is introduced. Comparator is a single device or a single application which does not carry any kind of a feedback. Just see here. Here I have not given any kind of a feedback in this circuit. For that purpose, comparator is a closed circuit, or it is also called as an open circuit. Then what involved in that comparator? Comparator compares to, that is means comparator, if suppose you are giving voltage to two input terminals of the op-amp, then it is also okay. If you are giving two currents related to that comparator as an input, then it is also okay. According to that, comparator will compare the inputs and will give us output. Then what happened? See, comparator to compares two voltages or currents, and output is a digital signal indicating which is large. Two analog input terminals and one is a output terminal. Then what is the output we observe? That is, either output is either 1 or either 0. When the output is 1 came into picture, while positive terminal of the op-amp is in a having higher level, then it will be introduce a positive output. That is, positive output is nothing but 1 and negative output is nothing but 0. While the negative output came into picture, that is a V2 input is a higher than V1, then we got that negative output. That means the output will be introduced here as a 0. The op-amp's output voltage is limited by the supply voltage. Then short information related to that integration. See here, integration, in that integration, negative feedback is given along with capacitor C. Then what it will give us, just see shortly, afterward we see in detail structure related to that integration, comparator and all these things. Here just see overview. Performs the mathematical operation of a integration V out. What is the mathematical output of from that V out? V out is T1 is equal to V out T0 minus 1 by RC integration of T tends to T0 to T1 V in T dt. What it seems, the output signal is determined by the length of the time a voltage is present at its input as the current through the feedback loop charges or discharges the capacitor as the required forms. Then next is a differentiation. In the differentiation, what we observe, in the differentiation V1, V2 voltages is applied for the negative terminal and positive terminal respectively. Then for the grounding purpose also one resistance is connected and feedback is given to negative terminal of the op-amp. Then differentiation gives us differential output. The amplifier the difference between the two voltages but does not amplify the particular voltage. That means it will be amplifies differentiated output voltage but not individual. Then what is the equation of that differentiation? Just see here shortly, afterward we will see in detail. Vout is equal to AD. AD means what? AD means differential gain. We observed earlier. Then Vin plus, that means positive terminal input, minus Vin negative, that means negative terminal input. That means here is input related to non-inverting terminal of the op-amp. Here input is related to inverting terminal of the op-amp. Then plus AC means what? Common mode gain. Here again Vin positive plus Vin negative. Input given to non-inverting terminal of the op-amp and input given to inverting terminal of the op-amp. Then what do we mean by AC? Just see here. AC means common mode gain and AD means differential gain. Then next is charge amplifier. This is a circuit related to charge amplifier. This circuit is used for charging the amplifier. Just see shortly. Constructed using op-amp with a feedback capacitor. Just see here, negative feedback along with capacitor is given to this circuit. The charge amplifier just transfers the input charges to another reference capacitor and produces an output voltage equal to voltage across the reference capacitor. This voltage is produced along with this capacitor feedback towards that output. The circuit acts as a charge to voltage converter. That means that circuit is converts that current into voltage converter. For that purpose, that circuit is also called as a current to voltage converter or I2V converter or charge amplifier. All these names are same. The input impedance of the circuit is almost zero. Then capacitance multiplier. In that capacitance multiplier, what we observed, only the positive terminal is along with number of components and negative terminal is a feedbackly connected via output towards again that upper circuit. What it says us, uses an amplifier to make a capacitor function like a capacitor that is much larger, used as a capacitance multiplier in a such a way that multiple small physical capacitance are combined in an integrated circuit technology to yield a large overall capacitance. The aim is to often a multiply the original capacitance value hundreds and thousands of time. Oscillators, in that words it shows that it will be used for providing oscillations. Just see in shortly what oscillator says, produces a repetitive oscillating electronic signal often in a sine wave or a square wave. It will converse the direct current, that is a DC, from a power supply to an alternating current, which is useful for us for home appliances and any other appliances. With DC current, we cannot directly apply to any devices. Then device, if we are going to apply that DC current directly to any electronic device, then device will damage. For that purpose, DC, there is a main function or a main important role that we have to play, that is, we are always converting the DC current into AC, and that conversion will be take place by using this oscillator. That means it is a very very important role related to this oscillator. It contains an energy storing element, a capacitor or a mower, rarely an inductor. Then next is active filters types. What are the types of active filters? Low pass filter, high pass filter, band pass filter, band reject filter. That means active filters are categorized in a four types. The first type is a low pass filter, the next is a high pass, band reject. What is this active filters? A filter contains a device like an op amp. LP means low pass filter, allows low frequencies and blocks high frequencies. High pass filter allows high frequency and it will block low frequency. Cutoff frequency. A cutoff frequency is a frequency level above or below where a device fails to operate. That is called as a cutoff frequency, and that cutoff frequency plays important role in high pass filter as well as low pass filter along with this active filter. Then low pass filter transfers a function. What that function transfers? Hs is equal to minus RWWC divided by SR1 plus R1 omega C. That is a low pass filter's cutoff frequency. What is that cutoff frequency of low pass frequency? Omega C is equal to 1 upon R2C, which is the angular cutoff frequency. If this frequency is not linear, it is angular. Consider one. This is a low pass filter devices. Circuit diagram. Then low pass filters passes low frequency signals with amplification and a gain control. Low pass filter and non-inverting unity amplifier is considered for the low pass filter. Low pass filter, that means capacitor is connected in series with positive terminal, and resistor is connected in series with along with that positive terminal, and capacitor is connected in parallel manner along with that positive terminal. Then what is the cutoff frequency related to that? Fc is equal to 1 upon 2 pi RC for that. And this is non-inverting unity amplifier, that means it will be produces a gain, always unity. Just see, whatever the input is given to this side, output is like same. Okay, this is a input voltage, this is a output voltage. Then active low pass filter with amplification. The amplitude of the output is increased by the pass band gain AF of the amplifier. That means here we have amplified that low pass filter along with that amplitude pass gain, that is the AF. Just see here, whatever the input given to input terminal, this is the amplified output towards that output stage. Then frequency response curve. Frequency response curve for that low pass filter is here 0 dB gain. Always we are going to representing that frequency response curve. It is a gain versus frequency response. Gain is always represented in y axis and frequency is always represented in x axis, because gain terminology is nothing but output quantity divided by input quantity, and for that output divided by input we are going to always considering that voltage quantity, and voltage we are always representing in y axis. For that purpose, gain is here represented in y axis and frequency is represented here in a x axis. The gain is equal to 20 log to the base 10 V out divided by V in. That means here the gain is converted into dB. Here we are going to considering voltage terminology. If suppose here we are going to convert that is a power terminology, then how we are going to converting the gain into dB? That 10 log to the base 10 V out divided by V in, instead of that power terminology we are also using. Then this is a passband gain. Then how that gain is increased? Gain is increased in a sum limit. then again that response goes straightforward, and at the time of that or a frequency, some frequencies there is reaches, that frequency is nothing but cutoff frequency. That means the curve is does not increase or decrease, it will stay steady. Apart from that, the slope is goes down. This is a decade proportion. The decade is a minus 20 dB per decade. This is a cutoff frequency 159 Hz. Like this, minus 3 dB decade, and this is a 45 degree angle is here, and here is a minus 20 dB per decade represented here. Then next is a, what is the cutoff frequency? Fc is equal to 1 upon 2 pi CR2 Hz. Then high pass filter passes high frequency signal with amplification and the gain control. Here just see, only the resistor and capacitor is a position is a changed in comparison with low pass filter. That is, a capacitor is a connected in series with positive terminal and resistor is a connected in parallel with positive terminal. Again here we have used similarly like your low pass filter, unity gain amplifier is also here used. Here same unity gain amplifier is used, that is a non-inverting unity gain amplifier. For that purpose here, whatever the input given to that circuit, we are applying just that input towards positive terminal, and a negative terminal is just connected for the feedback purpose. This is a high pass filter and this is a non-inverting unity gain amplifier. Then first order active high pass filter with unity gain. Why we are calling here as a first order active high pass filter with unity gain? Because here we have connected the non-inverting unity gain amplifier. For that purpose, whatever the output represent or introduced by that high pass filter is a unity gain amplifier. And why the word here came into picture, that is a first order active high pass filter? Because here only one high pass filter circuit we are connected. For that purpose, its order is a first order active high pass filter. If suppose we are connecting more circuits related to that high pass filter, more than 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like this, the order is goes on changes. That is a second, third, fourth, fifth, like this. Then next is a active band pass filter. Then active band pass filter is a frequency selective filter circuit. That means only limited frequency or selected frequency is a passed out throughout the circuit and other frequencies are rejected. Then range is a set between the two cutoff frequencies point. What is the range selected for that frequency pass out? That range is totally dependent upon two cutoff frequency of that point, that is a lower frequency FL and the higher frequency FH. While attenuating any signal outside of these two points, that means outside of these points, these signals are does not transmitted towards that output. Made by cascading together a single signal, that is a low pass filter, and a signal that is a high pass filter. That means here the active band pass filter is made by cascading of that. Cascading is nothing but output of a first circuit is connected towards that input of first filter. Then this process is nothing but cascading. Thus the output of low pass filter is connected along with output of high pass filter, and the cascading is done for the reproduction of that active band pass filter. Then this is a block diagram related to this, that how we are going to cascading that low pass filter output and high pass filter. Just here Vin input is given towards that high pass filter, then the it output is amplified by using that amplification, then output is given towards that low pass filter, and then here output is introduced. Then next, active band pass filter circuit diagram. Here also, here this is an amplified circuit, that is a negative amplifier is used or positive. Here is the input given towards that positive amplification, that is a non-inverting terminal of the op-amp. Here is a high pass filter stage, here is a low pass filter stage. Then next is a, this is a graphical representation related to each and every stage. This is a high filter, that is a curve response increasing amplification, which is a steady state, and then low pass filter is a decreasing stage. And how we are giving output from that band pass filter is, see here, this is a high pass filter range, this is a low pass filter range, it is a lower cutoff frequency, it is a higher cutoff frequency, and that this band is a passed by using that band pass filter circuit. Then band reject filter, it is a totally controversial for that band pass filter. Band stop filter reject a specified band of the frequency and passes all other frequencies. The response is opposite to that of band pass filter. This is the circuit diagram related to this. Then graphical representation of that band pass filter is, this is a stop band stop band bandwidth is f2 minus f1. That means higher cutoff frequency minus lower cutoff frequency is nothing but bandwidth, and that bandwidth is considered as a band stop filter, or that band stop filter is also response is also called as a band reject response, and this is decayed as a 3 dB decay. Thank you. This is all about basic information related to analog circuit. I hope you know all these things. If any query, then directly comment to me. Thank you.